girls. Just act natural.
You will see two separate views of love American style. And our first story about a country boy and his first love in the big city, called Love and the Phone Book.
Edna, listen, the reason I called, I wonder if you'd like to go out with a friend of mine. He's an old high school friend who just got into town from Paris. No, Paris, Indiana, but he's still groovy. Sure, tonight. Oh, well, how about tomorrow night? Well, maybe next week, either you or a friend. Yeah, love you too. Bye. Struck out again.
Look, Ray, don't feel like you have to get me a date.
You want to meet girls, don't you?
Well...
Of course you do. Otherwise, you would have stayed in Indiana and watched the alfalfa cross-pollinate. What are old friends for?
You've done enough for me, letting me stay with you, showing me around.
Child's play. Muriel. No, she likes guys who wear lizard skin hip huggers. Hey, Mildred. She's your type, a real country girl. Smokes pot in a corn cob pipe.
She smokes a pipe?
Yeah, forget it. She's not your type. I've just about run out of girls. What's your astrology sign?
The two fish, but I don't...
Pisces. What luck. Rosalind has a real thing about Pisces men. She won't even go out with Scorpio or Libra. Just Pisces. A Pisces answered.
That's all right. You try. Must have used up $2 worth of dimes.
Man, I gotta pay my phone bill. You sort of get out of touch when girls aren't free to call you when they're ready. They must go through a lot of frustration.
There'll be another day.
This is your first weekend in the big city. I can't blow that for you. There must be some girl. Hey, here's one. Look at this.
If you want an easy date, call KL50710 and ask for Patty. You can't just call up some strange girl.
Why not? She has references. Give me a dime.
Sure, but I couldn't just go out with some strange girl.
Look, city girls are different. You may get lucky. If not, you've got nothing to lose. It's ringing. Here.
Me?
Hello?
You said hello. What do I do?
Say hello.
Hello.
Who is this?
Who is this?
It's you.
It's me. Who's this?
Patty, who is this?
What do I say?
Tell her you love her. Tell her you want to meet her. Tell her anything.
Who is this and why are you mumbling?
Hello, you don't know me, but I love you. I mean, I don't love you because I don't know you, but I'd like to love you. I mean, I'd like to meet you. I mean...
Is this some sort of obscene phone call?
Oh, no. I just want to make friends.
This is an obscene phone call.
No, honest. See, I just called because I found your name on this phone booth wall.
What?
Yeah, that's right. It says, if you want an easy... and then your number.
Well, I'm not that kind of a girl. And you're just some cruel, dirty person. And if you call me again, I'll...
No luck, huh?
You thought it was a dirty phone call.
But you said you loved her.
She almost cried.
Some women will do anything to get a little attention. I'm too big for this town.
What's that?
Aftershave lotion. It's called the Mann Act.
Sounds like something a policewoman ought to wear.
What do you know about the finer things? Nothing smells good to you unless it kills corn blight. Sorry I couldn't get a date for you tonight.
That's all right. I'm not in the mood now anyway.
Now, that phone call with a girl isn't still bothering you, is it?
I did hurt her feelings.
Ah, forget it, will you? Look, why don't you, me, and Carol go out and do something, all three of us?
But I don't even know Carol.
Neither do I.
I know you want to be alone. I think I'll just stay home and read.
Stay home and read?
Yeah, I don't want to get in your way.
In that case, would you mind going to the movies to read?
The movies?
Just for a couple hours. See, Carol's never seen a color TV, and I sort of invited her over to watch mine.
But this isn't a color TV.
What's the difference? Well, have a couple of drinks first, then some soft music, small talk. By that time, who wants to watch TV? It's a cinch.
You think it'll work? I mean, how many color TVs did they make with round picture tubes?
Doesn't matter. She's not coming over here to watch TV anyway. Esty. One, two, three. Well, gotta go. Can I drop you someplace?
No. I'll walk or take a bus.
Okay, I should be back in half an hour.
Be gone by then.
Enjoy the movie.
Thanks. Oh, hey! Isn't there a movie house a couple of blocks down the street?
That ratty little one on Fillmore?
Yeah.
Dave, I think you should find another movie. There's some kind of weirdish people going there.
Well, that's okay. I only want to kill a couple of hours.
Well, I just don't think you'd get anything out of the movies.
What's playing?
Arsenic and Old Leather and Lavender Cowboy.
Misinterpreted my intentions regarding that call.
Hello?
Don't hang up, it's me.
Who's me?
Me, the guy who made the obscene phone call earlier. Can't say anything right.
Listen, if you don't stop calling me, I'm gonna call the police.
Don't do that. I don't blame you and I won't call you again. I just called this time to apologize. I'm sorry.
Apologize? I didn't know perverts apologized.
Well, I am. I'm not a pervert, apologizing, I mean. And it wasn't a dirty phone call. You see, my friend was trying to get me a date, and he couldn't. So he saw your number in the wall, and he called you, and he stuck the phone in my hands, and I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make you cry. If I was a girl, I'd be pretty sore at me, too.
I guess I accept your apology.
Oh, thanks. That really makes me feel better. You see, I'm just not the kind of a guy who makes obscene phone calls to strange girls.
I see. You only make obscene calls to girls you know.
No, I don't even know any girls.
Not here, anyway. I just got in town from Paris.
Paris, Indiana. And I don't know anybody here but Ray. He's the guy who saw your name on the wall.
Would you do me a favor?
Anything.
Would you erase my name off that wall?
I can't do that. It's scratched in the wall with a knife or something.
A pen knife?
Could be.
A pearl-handled pen knife?
It's kind of hard to tell.
How's my name spelled?
P-A-T-T-I.
It's misspelled. I spell my name with a Y.
You want me to correct it?
No, but now I know who did it. Morgan Delphonse. He always spelled my name with an I. He was captain of the baseball team.
Why would he want to write a terrible thing like that about you?
It's a long story, but basically the only thing we had in common was that I'm a girl and he's a boy.
So when I got home and found tobacco stains in my collar, I swore I'd never take out another girl to chew.
Do you know we've been talking for almost 3 hours?
No kidding. Gee, I'd better let you go. But I'm really glad I called you back. You're really a nice girl.
Well, I'm glad you called back, too.
I hope you don't take this wrong. But, well, I'd kind of like to meet you sometime. I know we haven't been introduced.
I'd like to meet you, too. You sound a lot different from most of the guys I meet.
Really? Well, I'm not doing anything tomorrow night. If you're not doing anything tomorrow night, we could go to a movie.
It's a date.
Well, how do I get to your place?
I tell you what, since I have a car and you don't, I'll pick you up.
Oh, that is nice of you.
Well, how do I get there?
Well, you go down University Street till you see a big marquee saying Lavender Cowboy. Sorry, didn't mean to disturb you two.
I don't mind if my pillow doesn't mind.
Well, I thought that... How was your date?
She walked in, said that's not a color TV, and walked out.
Sorry your plan didn't work.
Sorry the girl didn't work out. She's here and gone in less than a minute. It's the second shortest date of my life. That was a flick.
I didn't go. You know that girl we called this afternoon?
Yeah.
Well, I called her back and we ended up talking for hours.
You're kidding.
Nope. We're going out tomorrow.
You're kidding.
She's even coming here to pick me up.
You're kidding.
We're going to a movie.
You're kidding. Dave, a totally strange girl's coming over to a totally strange man's apartment. A totally strange man who made a totally strange phone call to her before.
I explained that to her.
You can't take her to a movie.
Where should we go?
Nowhere. You have everything you need in this room. Drinks, couch, color TV. Ah, you look great. She'll fall all over you.
If I don't fall all over myself first.
No, don't worry. Just keep your cool. You can borrow my plaid sports coat.
Thanks.
Plenty of vodka. Hey, you've got everything you need. Both of the glasses are clean.
What am I gonna do with these suitcases?
What are you doing?
I just thought I'd pick up some of this stuff.
Touch nothing. My place is always a little junked up for a reason. These suitcases take up half the couch. She has no choice but to sit right next to you.
She can sit in the armchair. She can't sit in the armchair.
Notice that there's nothing junking up the bed.
I don't think I can do this. She really seems like a nice girl.
Your trouble is you're afraid.
It's not that.
Look, look, look. Just ease into it gradually. First, ask her to sit down. Make small talk. Be charming, witty. Mix drinks, then give one to her just as you ask if she wants one. Since it's already made, she can't refuse.
It all seems very sneaky.
Right. Now listen to every word. First, you put on some soft, sexy music. Then you tell her to make herself comfortable. Take off her shoes.
Her shoes?
For openers. Now it starts getting heavy. You casually show her this little dude.
Nudes by famous masters.
Some people call it art. I call it dirty.
I don't think she's
gonna... Sure she will. And while she's staring at the dirty pictures, you're sneaking closer and closer. And you put your arm around her.
I don't think these pictures are dirty.
Where's your head at? Look at that picture of Venus de Milo. Naked, no arms or legs. Tell me that doesn't appeal to prurient interests.
Well, I think the naked body is kind of beautiful.
Exactly. All you're trying to do is get her beautiful. Here's the sneaky part. Take a few yawns and tell her you've had a hard day and you're tired. You suggest skipping the movie and just staying here and talking. If she goes for it, you've got it made. That's when you make your play.
I think it'd be better if we just went to a movie.
And be eternally sorry?
It might be a good movie.
A movie that good hasn't been made. Will you listen to me? If you take things a step at a time, you'll know where you stand.
I guess so. I've got a feeling that she's going to end up calling me obscene again.
Thank you.
Are you Dave?
Yeah. Are you Patty? Come in, sit down. There. Gee. Well, you're even prettier than your voice.
Oh, what a sweet thing to say. Thank you.
Well, I've talked to girls with beautiful voices before, and then I met them, and, well, I was glad they had beautiful voices, because everybody should have some good feature.
You have a nice way of putting things.
Can I get you something? A pretzel.
Oh, I'd love a drink. I'm really thirsty.
Okay. I have vodka and orange juice.
Good, I'll have one.
Which one?
Vodka and orange juice.
Oh, the two together kind of one.
Not too strong, though. I've been shopping all day, and I'm kind of keyed up from fighting the crowds.
I know. I've never seen such a big city. Seems a shame they can't chop down some of the buildings and make trees out of them.
Oh, love me softly.
Beg your pardon?
The new album by the Love People. Mind if I play it?
Oh, go ahead.
I love rock music, but sometimes soft music is the best.
Ray is never going to believe this.
I guess I'm just a romantic at heart.
Ray will never believe this. I don't know too much about mixing drinks. I hope it's all right.
It's fine.
Are you sure?
Just the way I like it.
You know, after talking to you on the phone last night, I feel like I've always known you.
Me too. You know, you make a person feel so at ease. You mind if I take my shoes off?
No.
I'm not usually this informal, but I've been shopping all day and my feet are really tired. You know, I dated that baseball captain for 3 months and never felt this relaxed with him. I wonder why.
I don't know, but I bet that's why I wrote your number up on the wall.
I mean, if I didn't keep my guard up at all times, I would have been just another statistic in the girls' batted in column.
Well, you make me feel very relaxed.
Oh, nudes by famous masters. Is this yours?
No. Ray collects the dirty pictures.
I like nudes, don't you?
Yes, nudes.
Michelangelo's Adam.
Let's talk about clothes.
I hate clothes, especially in the summer. I feel so confined. I like to take baths just so I can take all my clothes off. It makes me feel so free.
Wow. Nothing. Nothing.
Is something wrong with your jaw?
Oh, no. I was just yawning. I'm kind of tired.
Me too. Listen, if you don't want to go to a movie, we don't have to.
We don't? I mean, it'd be kind of nice to just talk and get to know each other and whatever.
That's fine with me.
Fine. Fine. I just found out that if you take a second swallow, it helps to kill the bad taste of the first swallow.
Doing?
For whatever part. What'd you do that for?
That's for being just like the baseball captain. Only you're worse. He was obvious and you're just sneaky.
I didn't do anything sneaky. I was...
What really makes me mad is that I fell for that shy, dumb country boy routine.
But I am shy and dumb.
And sneaky.
Explain.
There's nothing to explain. You're obscene.
Well, you're the one who took your shoes off!
You're obscene. You're obscene.
Maybe I am. I did make her cry again. K-L-5-O-1. They painted over my number. K-L-5-O-1-7-O. Was it KL6? I'll be finished in a minute, officer. I'll only be a minute.
What you doing?
Scratching the paint off the wall. I'm almost finished.
I think you're finished now.
No, I've got another number left.
Wrong. I think the old cliche is your number's up.
What?
Defacing private property, that's a misdemeanor. Let's go.
Oh, you don't understand. See, there's a girl's number under that paint, and I have to call her. She thinks I'm obscene.
Oh?
Yeah. She thinks I lured her up to my place to... To do what I did.
And what was that?
Well, if she didn't understand, I don't think you would.
Why don't we go downtown and talk to the sergeant? He understands these things.
Don't worry, kid. I'll take you with me. Ain't been a jail maid that can hold me.
Thanks.
I'm making a break.
I think I'll break out tomorrow. Right now, I got a little headache.
You're allowed to make one phone call.
Ray's phone is disconnected. I can't remember Patty's number. I don't have anybody to call.
How fast your friends forget you when you've been down on your luck a few years.
Why don't you call information? They can give you the girl's number.
Don't call information. Think how fast is a call.
We do not. He used his dime to call a liquor store. Call information.
That's a great idea.
Thank you.
It's a bad idea.
One out of two, amen.
I mean, it's a good idea, but I can't remember Patty's last name. She only mentioned it to me once.
We'll try to remember.
Let's see. It started with an S. Simpson. No.
Samuels.
No.
Sweeney.
No.
Elephant. Amnesia.
No. Search. Seizure.
No, no.
Fork.
Package.
Solicit. No. Steel.
Anderson.
Panavision.
Surrender.
No. No.
Jones.
That's it.
Jones.
No, Smith. Patty Smith.
Do you know the correct spelling?
Thanks.
You trying to search me?
No.
Thanks.
Can I borrow your pencil? I don't want to forget it a second time.
Sure.
Thanks. Yes. I'd like the number for Miss Patty Smith, please. No, Smith. S-M-I-T-H. K-L-5-0-7-0-0. Thanks.
This.
Who else do you know who has to start a conversation by saying, don't hang up? Look, I'm in jail.
Well, at least you know your place.
Please listen. Ray's phone is disconnected, and you're the only person I can call. You've got to come down and bail me out. Just as soon as it snows where?
You heard me.
Boy, did I. Dad was right, boy. Boy, oh, boy, Dad was right.
What's that supposed to mean?
Dad said to be wary of girls who get you thrown in jail. Well, I've never been in jail before, and it's your fault I'm here now.
Don't blame me.
Well, you're the reason I'm here. They painted the phone booth, and I was scratching the paint off your number, so they arrested me. I just wanted to apologize, although it was your fault.
My fault?
You're the one who asked for drinks. You're the one who put on romantic music. You're the one who said we didn't have to go to the movies. And you're the one who hates clothes and likes to look at pictures of naked guys. And I'm the one who's in jail. Boy, that's justice.
You mean you thought that I...
Now, what would you think if I did all those things to you?
I'd have thought that you were trying to do just what I accused you of trying to do.
Right. And I'll tell you something else. I wouldn't let you bail me out of jail if you were begging me.
Dave.
What?
I'll be right down to bail you out.
Gee, you will? It all seems kind of funny now.
Yes, but I'm sorry it happened.
That's all right.
Well, what'll you do now?
I don't know. Go home, settle down, go to heavy equipment school.
But you could do all that right here in town. That is, if you wanted to stay.
Do you want me to stay?
Yes, if you want to stay.
I'd stay if you wanted me to stay.
Stay.
Okay, I'll stay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Hello?
Patty Smith?
Yes?
You don't know me, but I found your name and number on the wall at the police station. I figure any girl's got her name on the cell block wall must be a real swinger.
You found my name on the cell block wall?
Uh-huh. And I just got released. I thought I'd pick up a gallon of daiquiri mix and you and I could go out twisting.
Thank you, but no.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. I just wrote it there so I wouldn't forget it. It's not like the baseball cap. Well, I guess I'd better go now.
Thank you.